The word essence means so many things, but here at the Essence Music Festival, it also means excellence. My man Ward is at the 365 Black Awards presented by McDonald's, and he has a lot of excellent people who are being honored for their involvement in the community. Stay right there.
Organization people and partners who make the Essence Festival possible. I mean, this is truly a village to have an event of this scale and experience that culminates here, but we had a conversation about what's happening and who will be here for 9 months leading into the festival. And I'm very excited about, you know, what's happening in the evening, the wonderful artists who are performing, Jill Scott, Maxwell, Charlie Wilson, a favorite, of course, Beyonce, new artists such as Emily Sandé, very excited she performed last night, and extraordinarily looking forward to our Community Day and the Empowerment Experience stage, where we will have a commemoration of the seminal moments of the 50th anniversary of the Civil Rights Movement. Representative John Lewis, Burley Evers Williams. We are truly excited to honor our heroes on whose shoulders we stand.
And that's what it's all about, giving back. We know this is Essence Musical Festival, but when you think of Essence Music Festival, it's so much more. It includes the food, the atmosphere, the city, the people. So when you hear the word essence, what exactly does that mean to you?
To me, essence means what is in our heart, what is in our soul, not what is on the surface. And you know, that's what we endeavor to do, find, you know, what moves us, propels us forward. So we're excited about being here at Essence.
First, McDonald's is a corporation that embraces diversity. It believes in giving back to the community. It believes in being deeply rooted in community. I'm the chairperson of an organization called the National Black McDonald's Owner Operators Association. We have almost 300 members, 1,400 restaurants, but we provide over 72,000 jobs throughout the United States. We have a tax base of over $300 million that we pay in various communities, local tax, USA tax, and also real estate taxes. But we provide over $750,000 a year in scholarships to the community for young people like yourself. So it's really important that we recognize individuals out there, but we also believe in giving back to the community. Very important.
I'm looking forward to celebrating people who reach out into the community and help to uplift others, and that is so important to me. People who value education or hard work or perseverance and just kind of value giving back, and it's just like it's everything.
I think of all the amazing performers that have come before me, paying homage to just great black entertainment, women, men, you know, people who hold and exude the essence of the spirit of black people. And it's great to be here in New Orleans celebrating. I'm doing a tribute to Gladys Knight today, and I'm thrilled. You know, she's been one of those iconic performers who has lit up our lives with her music and her voice and her grace and her style and her beauty. And I'm really excited to pay homage to her tonight.
It came as a surprise to me, receiving this nomination and this award, but what I really hope to stand for is that young people can lead the change they wish to see in the world. Greeningfort powers 2,000 young people who make a global impact on our world and our environment today, now. And I think adults can value that and see that and provide more opportunities for young people to be those leaders.
And of course, we're at the Essence Music Festival. But when you think of the word essence, what exactly comes to mind?
I think there's something special about the journey that African Americans have made through the years. And we have a really powerful story to tell of overcoming a lot of pressures and things that have held us back. And it's worth celebrating, you know, where we are today and who we are and our culture. That's who we are.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ozzie P. Henson. When you hear the word essence, what exactly comes to mind?
Essence, I think of spirit, your soul, everything that makes you who you are.
Good. And this is the host of the event tonight.
Yes.
What are your expectations?
I just know it's going to be fabulous. I've seen behind the scenes. I was at rehearsal yesterday. You're in for a treat.
Taraji, I mean, is a beautiful woman inside and out, obviously, so I'm definitely excited to see her. And then Gladys Knight, man, I mean, being honored, you know, I'm really excited for that. Like, that's a piece of our history. That's something we get to take with us and tell for generations and generations. So anytime we get to honor somebody like that, you know, I love to be a part of it.
And a familiar face on TV, you know, you're on the game. What can your fans look forward to as far as future projects, man?
I'm starting a movie called The Christmas Card with Tatiana Ali and Jordan Sparks and Bill Cobb in a few days. And then, you know, hopefully working on a few other things.
It feels amazing. I've never been to this event before. I've never been to any of the Essence events. So to be here with beautiful Black African-American women that has, you know, integrity and prestige and inspiration, legends. This is amazing. I'm like freaking out right now.
I'm actually looking forward to the whole thing. I think one performance can't define how much talent is in this building or in this space right now. But I'm doing a tribute to Gladys Knight, and I'm eager to see her face once she's tributed. I think it's going to be amazing.
And when you say Essence Music Fest, you think food, fun, fashion, just the city of New Orleans and the atmosphere. What are some things that you have taken away from this weekend?
I just think everybody that comes to Essence Festival, it's like one big family reunion. You have a good time. It's a time to revel in the fact that we live good, we live out loud, we laugh, we eat, we have a great time, we dance, we have music, and we pray. And I think that's amazing.
What's up? Say what's up, man.
For production purposes, can you
say what's up?
What's up?
I feel like I'm in an audition. I am Omari Hardwick, 5'10". Do I need to get profile?
No, sir, not at all. All right, let's get straight to it, man. Essence Music Festival. You like the most hated man on TV right now?
Am I hated?
Yes, man. Being Mary Jane.
You hate me?
Nah, man, you cool in my book. You here doing this interview with me,
bro.
Man.
Thank you, my man.
But being Mary Jane, yeah. You know, a lot of feedback that's buzzing right now. Yep. Can you just speak on that project and what it's done for you?
I've done good TV before. Of course, everybody saw Dark Blue on TNT, which was a really great show and shouldn't have been canceled. I probably shouldn't have even had an opportunity to do this because that show, to me, should have maintained. But to work with Mara Brockakill and her partner in crime and incredible husband and mentor of mine, Salim, has been unbelievable. It's my second time working with him. I did Sparkle. And so I think it's awesome for BET to be on a different track. They got a different train going and it's on a different track. And I think I'd be remiss if I didn't say I'm proud that Mary Jane is the train that's trying to get them on a different track. And so it's great, man. It's a great, well-written, zany, brilliant story about a newscaster, woman, type A, assertive, definitive woman who knows how to get through life, but yet doesn't know how to get through her love life. She's a mess in that department, and so it's great. It's great to have characters written so smartly. We need better characters written, you know what I mean? So it's great. It's great to be part of it. It's 4 million viewers, so I guess the people liked it.
Uh-huh.
And they hated me. That's what you said.
I don't know how that works. Some people
you
love to be hated.
That's
true. But man, Essence Music Festival. When you hear the word essence, what comes to mind?
Where we're going. A lot of people might say when they hear the word essence, they think about what we've done and who our people have been and our ancestry. And, you know, from Paul Robeson to Langston Hughes to Cicely Tyson. If you're talking about the world of entertainment.
4 million views, we're moving forward, baby.
So to me, the essence of us is only as good as where we end up. You know, you're only as good as your last play. So the last play is as brown and black people is yet to be seen. And so I believe that the essence of us is what we can get to, is what we can accomplish. Young brothers like you hollering at me.
Oh, man, thank you, man.
What's
thank you.
Name, man?
War Colin.
War. Omari, man.
Nice to meet you.
Oh, Don't patronize, 'cause I can't make you love me if you don't. You can't make your heart feel something it won't. Here in the dark, in this final hour, oh, if you don't.